So what are your guys' names?
Eric.
Natalie.
Derek and Natalie. And you guys have been coming down to City Hall for Occupy Philly for a few days?
Yeah, every day.
Pretty much every day?
Yeah.
So what's been, like, the vibe overall for you guys?
I like hanging out and smoking and, you know, just get the feel of what's going on. And, like, I was here the one night when they were, you know, asking opinions. I like to have the best opinion with the survey to say what should our be our message on a national, state, local, and international level. I don't know. I think it's just evolving every day. It's very cool.
Yeah. Everybody that I've talked to is informed and they're reaching out. They're offering you different opinions. Hey, you know, this guy over here, he came up with that, he said that. There's just like a really good, like, it's a family vibe.
There's a community vibe, definitely. You know what I mean? And, like, I came down here, like, I've been out first for a couple of weeks, and I come down here and have lunch and hang out and talk to people and, like, try and get involved as best I can. But, you know, it's, they're offering the basic resources to be able to come out here and have a good time. And basically just, like, go camping with City Hall stuff instead of out in the woods, which, who knows how it's going to happen again, you know?
Right.
And everyone has the information that they're passing on to someone else, just, like, spreading through. Like, everyone I'm talking to has knowledge about something and an opinion, you know? It's not just, like, people are taking advantage.
A unified message seems to be what's hard to get, you know, because there's so many different voices, you know, there is no one number one issue, there's multiple issues that will be addressed, and there's people representing every facet of every different issue that needs to be addressed out here, and that's pretty really good.
Yeah, I mean, I think the cool thing, what I've seen, you know, with here and on the website with technology, you know, with kind of spreading the message, is like the different groups that kind of get together to talk about, you know, different topics. I guess, is that kind of, you know, when people spread out, they're talking about, you know, different things, or is it, you know, one message or different messages, or?
I think that's the issue that needs to be addressed right now, you know what I mean? If you walk around and you just look at the flyers that are out, a lot of them are good messages, none of them are about a single message, you know. And unifying a single message is ideally, you know, not necessarily ideally, you know, having a set of demands or a list of demands that should, like, meant, like, I personally think that the banks and the corporations should pay back the bailout money. They should pay it back to our education system. So we basically have to loan the government, pay the corporation, which is being funded to the people. It went through the corporations, but it's ultimately our government funding and trickle-down effect into our education, maybe into our infrastructure here in Philadelphia, or other issues that many Congress need to be addressed.
And basically the message is, like, online, getting out in the public to get here to Occupy Philly and get involved and spread the word that way, listening to people, listening to speeches, going to the different tents that are talking about different things. And then you're spreading the word. The internet's a good way to get it out there, but most of us who are struggling financially aren't having an Android phone and going on Occupy Philly on Facebook, you know. It's about getting here and getting involved and spreading the word that way.
And, you know, being an internet resource, you know what I mean? If you're not from Philadelphia, if you're not from Wall Street or New York City, start it in your town. Go throw a tent up in a public area and say, look, I'm occupying. More people will come if they hear about it. I mean, I would stay down here. Stay through the winter, man. People are going to donate coats. You know what I mean? Donate space to you. So you don't leave. Until something happens. And right now, it's an infantile basis of what we want in official messages, but something's happening. If it keeps moving and it doesn't stop, then who knows what kind of progress we might get in a year, 2 years, imagine 2 years, you know, still living in the same spot.
The energy is pretty palpable, so with that being said, like, how long do you guys plan on staying? I mean, this, you know, could go on for a while then, until
it gets cold in the north. I'd say if you're in the north occupying, it's getting to the point where some states can migrate south.
Right.
And then, you know, hit up Atlanta, hit up southern Flint City, see how they feel about it. With the miners, they come back up here. I'm not saying everyone leaves, but the people who don't have the resources to keep themselves warm in the winter, they come. country, go south. You know, and keep occupying no matter where you are. I come down here every chance I get. I, you know, a couple hours I'm down here. Just because there's something going on. I mean, if there's people here you can talk to, you can volunteer in any capacity, whatever your issues might be. So,